In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger.
Thank you. of waiting advent ring. The tortoise stove is lit again. The lamp-oil light across the night has caught the streaks of winter rain. In many a stained glass window sheen, from crimson lake to hooker green. The holly and the windy hedge, and round the manor house green, will soon be stripped to deck the ledge, the altar, font, and arch and pew, so that the villagers can say, the church looks nice on Christmas Day. Provincial public houses blaze and corporation tram cars clang. On lighted tenements I gaze where paper decorations hang. And bunting in the red town hall says, Merry Christmas to you all. And London shops on Christmas Eve are strung with silver bells and flowers. As hurrying clerks the city leave to pigeon-haunted classic towers. And marble clouds go scudding by the many steepled London sky. And girls in slacks remember Dad, and oafish louts remember Mum. And sleepless children's hearts are glad, and Christmas morning bells say, come. Even to shiny ones who dwell safe in the Dorchester Hotel. And is it true? And is it true, this most tremendous tale of all, seen in a stained glass window's hue, a baby in an ox's stall, the maker of the stars and sea, become a child on earth for me? And is it true, or if it is, no loving fingers tying strings around those tissue fritteries, the sweet and silly Christmas thing, bath salts and inexpensive scent, and hideous pie so kindly meant, no love that in a family dwells, no caroling in frosty air, nor all the steeple-shaking bells, can with this single truth compare, that God was man in Palestine. And lives today in bread and wine.
Just another star tonight, the sky. Just another time. says this in John 1:4. It says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the Word that was God became flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Apostle Paul says this, he abandoned his sovereign position to become a man, who, being in very nature God, did not consider equality with God something to be grasped, but made himself nothing, taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness, being found in the appearance of a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even death on a cross.
His feet we humbly fall, crown him God. called Our Father, whose word has come among us in the Holy Child of Bethlehem. May the light of faith illumine our hearts and shine out in our words and our deeds. Through him who is Christ the Lord. Amen.
Send you my heartfelt thanks and special blessings for this Christmas and for the new year ahead.